My name is Scott Stanley. I'm a professor at the University of Kentucky College of Agriculture, Gluck Equine Research Center. My field of study is equine pharmacology and toxicology. I spent over 20 years in California running the drug testing laboratory at the University of California, Davis. My experience is investigating drugs and performance in racehorses to identify new methodology to detect those drugs. It's been fairly clear that our drug testing capabilities do not solve all the problems with environmental contamination, with therapeutic drugs, and the capability of laboratories ever increasing. We need a new way to pursue drug testing, and we developed a process called the Equine Biological Passport to investigate proteins and peptides that change in response to the treatment of an individual horse. Whether it's a natural product that has been used, a prohibited substance that's used, a therapeutic drug that's used inappropriately, or a completely new drug, we could use the Equine Biological Passport to answer those questions. With therapeutic medications, oftentimes we advise the trainers, the veterinarians, and the horsemen for withdrawal time. We have many different horses of different ages, different size, different sex. They don't all clear the drug at the same time. So the best we can do is provide a rounded time frame, which the drug will clear most of the horses. Sometimes when we have medication violations for therapeutic and non-therapeutic substances, the public misinterprets what those mean. The emerging new drugs make it problematic for us to cover all drugs all the time. It can take any time from weeks to months to get those drugs within a proper identification methodology. The Equine Biological Passport approach uses biomarkers that would change regardless of whether it was a drug that we knew or a new emerging threat that hasn't developed a specific test for. Those biomarkers are independent of the drug itself and work throughout the horse's physiological change. The Equine Biological Passport has the potential to be used for in-competition and out-of-competition testing. By being able to monitor those horses over the course of time, as a horse approaches a big race, we'll know whether or not they should be competing or, in fact, if they're an at-risk horse that might be selected for further investigation. Flexibility is paramount in this, being able to establish a program that can adapt quickly to the changing needs of the industry. One of the other challenges that we will have to face is we'll have to get regulatory modifications in place so that we can appropriately use Equine Biological Passport and implement regulatory oversight. It is a program that we can start soon, in months, but it'll expand and be more encompassing of all drugs in all cases over the next 3 to 5 years. The short-term goals will give us some quick answers. The long-term goals will really allow us to have a better regulatory oversight of the industry.